What's up with it, guys? We are back here with another video, mixing it up just a little bit here. This is gonna be a Holy Paladin BG commentary here. Trying to think here. I don't know that I need to go pure of heart, actually. Let's go. Light's grace. But yeah, so I've been playing my paladin a good amount the last week or so. I just got him level 120, so I figured I want to start doing some content on him. I'm playing Holy, obviously, right now. My UI is not super clean yet. I have to get my weak ores is not working or not letting me upload any new profiles for some reason, so I need to like reinstall it, and I just haven't messed with it yet. So apologize for it being a little disheveled. But yeah, so this is actually an RBG right now. So this is a rated battleground. What's our MMR? They are 1700. We're in like the ballpark of 1500. But yeah, so far I've been having actually a lot of fun with Holy Paladin. We'll see here. Basically, Light of the Martyr is really fucking good. I need to work on using it a little bit more than I have been. But it's really strong. Because it actually heals for a really significant amount. And in RBG situations, you're able to, I mean, there's so much peripheral kind of healing, you know, between different HOTs and things like that. So you're able to actually get the damage it does to you is negligible, even if you're just like spamming it for the most part. So being able to, oh fuck, I don't know if I can, I don't have anything to catch up to this guy. But so basically what I can do is I can cast Bestow Faith on myself and then spam Martyr on someone else. And I basically am guaranteeing that I'm going to get that heal from the shield. And then I can use Holy Shock in the same manner, basically, and just spam Light of the Martyr on other people and then Holy Shock myself. So that's kind of what I've been doing for single target. Again, like I just literally this week, I have not had a single reset at 120 yet. So I've just been just kind of trying to figure it out kind of as I go. I've looked at some guides here and there. But yeah, I've been having fun with it. I'm going to improve a bunch, I'm sure, over the next couple weeks of playing this, because I don't really know what I'm doing as of right now. But I've been having a lot of fun with it. And I have you have an amazing amount of cooldowns. So like here, watch, I'll go ahead. I'm going to trinket and then I pop wings. And you can see like how much I'm able to heal for just through doing damage. So this setup that I've been running, and like I haven't used, I'll go ahead like and I'll bop here. Let's do this. But basically this specific build that I'm doing, I've been like, it's like I have my kind of single target rotation. And then, oh shit, I might die here actually though. I don't have anything else for this. Nice. Okay, I have bubble. I'm gonna go ahead and bubble this. But my single target rotation is pretty straightforward, and then I have like wings, and then I can use my little AoE beacon talent and like end up doing a ton of AoE heals without even having to cast. Like it's all from damage from Judgment and Crusader Strike. Can we kill this guy? Hell yeah, get out of here, kid. But yeah, so you can see, like, dude, look at my fucking healing done, dude. Like, it's really crazy because I basically have... Oops, sorry, I hit the wrong shit. And so in this situation, too, I'm not even going... Another really big benefit to Holy Paladin is Pure of Heart, which allows you to cleanse and dispel a lot, which I'm not even running this time because they don't have an Unholy DK or Assassination Rogues. This Rogue's Outlaw, I think, right? That's out. That little thing is Outlaw, isn't it? But it's just, it's a really fun play style. So Holy is like super unique in the sense that it's basically all, okay, I'm going to go ahead and freedom myself here. Our warrior, oh, he went the other way. I'm by myself. That's bad of me. Pop my defensive, my little shield wall. But what does it say is that Holy is basically, it's a really cool, unique playstyle. So I've said this in a couple videos before, but just for those of you guys that haven't seen it, I used to actually main heals. I played a shaman for basically every expansion, the last like 3 or 4 expansions. And so that's like been my main. So I've kind of just always main healed. I played Resto Druid for a while at one point, and then, you know, I just kind of have swapped between different healers over the years. But Holy Paladin, I have not played very much in general. And it's a really fun playstyle, and it's super unique. All the healers, for the most part, have, you know, have their strengths and weaknesses. But Holy Paladin is really unique in the sense that it has a ton of cooldowns. So it's not so much that you have this really strong heal output, healing rotation, but you have a lot of amazing, valuable cooldowns to help, you know, help navigate certain situations. Nice, dude. So we got 2 caps there. So right now we're in a really good spot. And this is, our MMR is 1560. These guys are 1700. So we definitely shouldn't be dominating these guys the way that we are right now. But your boy's just pumping them heels out. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, so it's a really interesting spec, and basically what it comes down to is you have a ton of cooldowns and ability to keep other people up. It's a little bit more difficult when you get focused yourself, because basically you have bubble, and that's kind of your only real cooldown. You can also bop yourself, but that gets kind of tricky because it can be dispelled or purged really easily, so it's not nearly as strong. You have like a little shield wall, but... for the most part, I mean, obviously you're kind of a beefy plate wearing healer, so you have that advantage as far as just your general kind of durability in PvP, but you don't have a ton of cooldowns just for yourself. But for someone else, like the fact that I can use Light of the Martyr to instant heal someone else, and it heals for like almost about the same amount as Holy Shock, which is pretty impressive. And then I can use Blessing of Sacrifice on someone else. Oh, let's try and get this guy. And then that's a super, super strong defensive cooldown. So watch here. I'm gonna pop wings, and I pop my AoE, and you can see literally one judgment like tops off my whole team. It's pretty nuts. Pretty crazy, like burst AoE heals. And it's like right now, like, not only am I really tough to kill, I'm actually pumping out a really good amount of damage as far as just that offensive pressure if we're trying to secure a kill on a target. Another thing that's really helpful that is kind of unique when it comes to healers is for Holy Paladin, so much of your rotation and your, you know, value as a Holy Paladin is that you're kind of able to off DPS and not really mess up your rotation, if anything, kind of help your rotation through like Crusader Strikes and Judgments. So I set up all of these mouse over macros, so you can see like a lot of this stuff I have the enemies actually targeted as my target, but I'm still pumping out heals, and it's because I put everything as mouse over macros, so that way I can basically keep my mousing over whatever targets I'm trying to heal, but then I can like cast Judgment on cooldown, or like if they're in melee range of me, I can hit Crusader Strike in between those globals. And yeah, maybe you just get a ton of value. You can see like literally brand new tune. It's like every battleground I'm winning, it's like victory of Twin Peaks. Like, I literally haven't played this guy at all. I boosted him and then got him to 120. But yeah, it's been a lot of fun so far. And this spec is more of like the arena spec kind of that I run. Blinding Light, I probably would just go Fist of Justice here. But I'll do some more content when I run the Pure of Heart, because Pure of Heart is amazing. You can get... I'll have BGs where I'm getting like 250, 300 dispels. If they have like an Unholy DK or Assassination Rogues, things like that. And you just have a huge amount of utility, not to mention just your overall heal throughput and defensive cooldowns in general. So anyways, figured I would kind of go out here. So sorry if this was a little more scattered. I'm kind of still new to this playstyle, so I'm having to think a lot more about what I'm doing. But hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and I'll keep pumping some stuff out. I think I'm going to stream a little bit later today, probably doing some RBGs and stuff. So hopefully I catch you guys around. Please go and follow me on Twitch if you guys want to join on any of the live streams, and I will catch you guys in the next one. See ya.